Speaking of being an aggressor, I'm going to turn myself into a missile if I get close enough to this guy.
Make sure you do it backwards, though. Then you won't take any damage.
Yes, we found an exploit.
Are we in another race yet? Are we starting?
Grid auto spawn. Now we are.
I'm just holding my imaginary steering wheel. And
you're not going to do this for 20 minutes, are you?
Oh my god, look at this crash.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, the other random guy just gently put me into a fence.
Yeah.
It was surprisingly gentle. Just a caress. Like, you like fences.
He took you out to dinner first.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've spent 10 minutes trying to make this click-free backup system device that my mother's given me as a present work as storage instead of being just a backup device. Like, please just be a normal hard drive, thank you, but I've failed.
Nemesis, your car is just a pile of metal on my screen.
I think I have damaged it slightly.
On my screen, he has no wheels. His front end is all messed up. He has no engine, it looks like.
That's amazing.
Wall. Why do they have to be a thing?
What's this other driving game I hear people have playing? Is it called, Click Beam NG or something?
What are you doing?
Beam NG.
Yeah. Is that good? What's that all about?
It's
for a while.
Just a crash simulator.
Right.
It tries to simulate the entire car.
The physics of the entire car.
Yeah. Rather than... Oops, I did a crash.
So that's basically what the game is all about. Whoa, oops.
Yeah. But instead of a very complicated sprite, which is essentially what these are, they try and simulate how a car actually works. So it's a laggy mess that looks really good when you end the stuff.
Like, you can make a car explode into a bajillion pieces. Or just a spiked ball.
So it sounds like another Space Engineers.
Except with even less gameplay.
Yeah. Even less gameplay than Space Engineers. Yeah,
if Space Engineers decided that their whole game was just going to be about rotors.
That's quite funny.
Well, more accurately, it tried to actually simulate in real time the inner workings of the reactor.
Oh, so, my goodness.
I got you there. That makes sense. Yeah.
Could you imagine in Space Engineers if before you could make a reactor power plant, you actually had to invent fusion?
I would like that. If there was a science kind of build in Space Engineers, I would like that. So you had to start with something really, really simple and then build your way up.
Well, I'm quite enjoying that. What? Not that I'm playing it. I'm enjoying watching that simulator, My Summer Car. Has anyone else been watching
that? No, I've seen. There's a YouTuber that I do follow that has been playing it, but I haven't checked it out yet.
Generic B.
Generic B. About? That's the one.
Yeah. So I've been watching his videos and that. Very funny. Very funny. But it's a great game. It's like you're basically building your car from the ground up with every component just about as accurately as they can do, and it's quite impressive. Plus you're a drunk as well.
This is how we add amusing gameplay, right?
Yeah, that's right. It's a very interesting game. I've been trying to look at it, but I bought XCOM 2 for that.
Nice. I like that game.
Yeah, you do like that game. But you know the Humble Bundle Monthly thing that's been going for a while now? I've been looking at that for months, forever, and thinking, I'm not going to spend any money on that. But then XCOM 2 was a bonus. If you signed up for 1 month for Humble Bundle for $12, then you'd get XCOM 2 for nothing.
And that game is like still like what, $60 or
$60 Yeah. And I thought that's well worth it. So whatever games I get with the Humble Bundle monthly are a bonus, because XCOM 2 in itself is a great game. I don't know why I bother, because all I play is Binding of Isaac, so I don't even know why I bother buying any other games.
That's the game I haven't even played that. I haven't even watched the video, and I have no idea what that game's about. And you were like addicted to it.
It's been years of addiction to that game. It's such a simple gameplay, but it's such extraordinary depth to it. It's a strange one. They've just actually recently bought out another DLC for it, which is the final one that they're ever bringing out for it. So, of course, that reinvigorated my gameplay a little bit again.
Yeah,
I'm just watching endless videos of this BMG. I remember this as a demo and just mucking around with the demo of it. Yeah.
It looks like it'll eventually get there. And you'll be able to do something with it. It's just going to take a while.
That's right. There's another game.
I do have it. It's just the driving in it is just so... It's not fun. No reason to it.
Humble Bundle were recently giving away a few free games. I think we posted one of them up. It was one of the Grid or Dirt... One of the Dirt games, was it? Do you remember what it was?
It was probably Dirt.
Dirt 3 for free, because we all have that.
Yeah. Yes. I think so. I'm just having a quick look.
Or maybe it was the other Dirt.
Is that you, Boris? Showdown, maybe. I can't turn. You're being such a pill.
Neither can I.
Yeah, I think you're right, Wars.
Serious race now.
The battle of the non-steering wheeled cars. Get out of here! I won that one.
I've not come off well. I sound like
Is that a finish line finish there? Was that a very excruciating finish line finish? Or are you still racing?
No.
No,
we still
but
got
I might
entire lap.
We do eat. Oh my goodness!
This is a long
track. I think the time will
it's
run
one
out.
Of my favorite tracks in the game too, and I've got to go around it at like 30k an hour.
The jalopy. Speaking of games, that's another game, isn't it? Jalopy.
Yeah. Jalopy's really jalopy. Fun. It's more simple.
Yeah, it looks good.
My summer car.
Yeah. That does look good though.
Oh, damn it!
It was Dirt 3, and then it was Dirt Showdown that they gave away. I don't know what Dirt. Showdown
is so abysmally bad.
Oh, that's sad.
I'm imagining just two cars that drive at each other and play chicken.
But then they do donuts around each other while just annoying music plays, and people with baseball caps, but they're flat on the front, whatever they're called, they walk around drinking Monster Energy cans. That's the whole game.
Monster cats blood.
Did I say that or did you just make that up?
That's what you said.
It kind of came from what you said. Yeah, nearly, not quite, but nearly. That's the way the NID works, isn't it? Is this not otherwise known as Chinese whispers? That's probably not PC anymore, saying Chinese whispers. I mean, the Chinese no good at whispering? Is that the whole premise of the game? Don't get it. I think the Americans would be no good at whispering. Nothing against Americans, but I think it'd be the Americans that would be really bad at whispering because they've got quite loud voices.
They get very close up and then deafen you so you can't hear it. You get the first word, but the rest of it would not work. So that's how American whispers work.
So American shouting.
That's Texan whispers.
Texan
whispers. Okay.
I'll need to suggest that in my next child's party. We're going to play Texan whispers, everybody. Hey, Ashley!
Come here, real close. Mm-hmm. All right, ready? A Rochambeau you for it. I go first.
Oh, man.
And Rochambeau is just a fist fight.
No.
Do you not know the South Park reference to Rochambeau?
No, I don't.
Rock, paper, scissors.
No, Rochambeau was one person kicks the other person in the nether regions as hard as they can, and then the other person gets to do it back. I go first.
I've never heard that.
Whoever's standing at the end wins. I go first.
That's very funny. I like that. I haven't watched South Park in ages.
You see who goes first. I go first, though.
Yeah,
I go first. I would like to see two people try and kick each other in the balls
at the same time.
At the same time.
Yeah, that would be good. That would be perfect. Yeah. That would be graceful. Very graceful. And painful.
Very graceful.
Yeah. Yes, graceful.
Were you talking about my driving there?
Yeah, I'm just imagining your driving is very graceful. I'm imagining this whole race in my mind right now, and I'm hoping I'm getting the corners right.
Apart from Mars, this is actually kind of all right. Like, this one.
Apart from Mars, this is all right.
Yeah. dear.
I'm just trying to get through them, and they're like, nope, nope, nope.
Well, I'll have to go because I've got to go to my neighbor's for a cup of tea.
Mm-hmm. And by tea you mean scotch.
Oh, I wish. I've got a lads' night out tonight, actually. It's the final night out before the flight home tomorrow.
Oh, yeah.
And then it just takes about 3 weeks to fly home from Scotland to Australia. And I'll be back home eventually. So, I'll be back home Monday now, which is exciting. So, for all you viewers, as Sal would say, that will be
4 months
a week
from now.
Or two. Yeah, something. I'll go. I might even be dead. Yeah. By the time that you watch this episode, you never know. But until that, and I'll be able to join. I don't know if we're doing Grid every week or every second week, or I don't know what the schedule is, or whenever we feel like it.
Don't ruin the illusion. We do it like 20 minutes
every
before
day.
They see it.
That's right. It's almost right. Live.
It's almost a live stream. Right. Okay. Sorry. Yes.
A new thing coming to YouTube. There's like the normal YouTube videos, and then there's live streaming, and then there's the new thing coming that's called Almost Live, where you record it right like 15 minutes before it goes live. Yeah.
Nice.
And you're actually still playing. Uploading as you're
streaming. Yeah, as you're playing. Exactly. Yeah.
So your
computer would have to be an amazing monster to be able to render that fast.
Yeah. So all those watching, I've got 2 degrees of separation of liveness. Nearly,
that's right.
In that video, I like that. Okay, that's a new thing. It
2 degrees of liveness.
Yeah, worthwhile.
One of these episodes for me to render it in 1080p at 60fps takes me close to 2 hours to 3 hours.
Yeah, so you do need an upgrade if you want to go there. All right, that's the next upgrade for the almost liveness, 2 degrees of live on YouTube. we'll see you there.
Oh, and he left. Oh, he's back.
Sorry. That the mouse pad in the Apple's very sensitive. I just like lent my finger on it. All right.
That would have been right though. He could just walk away.
That's right. Like, and I'm out.
Middle of sentence.
Oh, yeah. Bye, Minty.
Let's pull a George Costanza, leaving a high note. I think that's just what Minty does.
Yeah.
Could you demonstrate leaving on a high note?
I don't want to because I'll destroy Waz's ears.
I wonder what the highest frequency is that you could transmit
and still hear
Discord.
It?
Well, no, like just in general, would it allow you to transmit things that are surely not? That'd just be a waste of bandwidth if it was transmitting everything you couldn't hear.
I think Discord
for bats.
We have to remember that computers can pick up a lot better, a lot wider range of sounds than humans can. So
probably all of them, I'm guessing.
I don't know if it filters out any of them. So,
but surely, like, it would have to. Otherwise, the voice activity would be going constantly, because there would be some mouse 3 blocks away complaining to its neighbor.
Yep. Well, you notice it too when you get a like higher quality microphone and all of a sudden it picks up noises around you that you didn't even know were there and you hear them back in the recording.
Your neighbors fighting next door.
Oh, my neighbors fight constantly. Not one of them. I've got good
I would
neighbors.
Fight if
I've
I was
old nosy neighbors. And then there's another set that are down further because we got a long block. And they just yell at each other. Perhaps I should record a video down there. And I don't know why. Probably not. I'd end up in hospital. Let's not do that. There we go. That's the
cool
life,
story, bro.
Birth and death of an idea in a few seconds.
Yeah, we saw the entire cycle.
That should be a segment, like a 5-minute show on PBS or something. The life and death of an idea with Forrest Barbershop.
I could see that on NPR. An NPR show that would, that's probably already on NPR.
I've pulled out my thing again. I really need to get set up.
Well, yes, but I mean, you have a show that isn't that, but it's just as awesome that you need to start doing again, Pravisham Laboratories.
That's a channel.
Yes, I know it is.
That's where
I'm plugging Boris's Pravisham Laboratories channel. And if anybody out there listening hasn't found it or listened to any all of them on there, you must. They're amazing.
They're so randomly stupid.
They're awesome. My favorite one was the girlfriend one. That one was so great.
I must sound like Monopoly Man in them because they were quite a while ago.
I'm gonna have to like download them and put them all on a CD and listen to them when I drive.
You know what? Actually, what I do now is I put them on my phone, and then when I'm driving around with like random people, just start playing them. Yes. Like, pretend they're on the radio and see what they do.
Try and change it.
Yeah, and every channel is just a different one of his recordings.
I think what you should do is put it on your car very loudly, and then drive down a street, but very slowly with a lot of pedestrians, and try and headbang to it with your windows. These cars aren't anywhere near as fun as I thought they were going to be.
Yeah,
not
another
that
kind
fast.
Of not.
Yeah, it's just this is a one-handed car. this is the sort of car where you don't pay attention to what's happening. I just went through Nemesis. I didn't really see a reason for it, but I did.
I got a penalty.
Oh, that's why you stopped then.
Oh, I see the ambulance on the side of the road. That's for me later.
This Brazilian is being a jerk.
Yeah, he's taking full advantage of the fact that it's collisions on. Yeah. I'll get him for you, Oz. Oh, no, I won't. Never mind. It's your turn again.
Oh well, now I gave him a fair chance. Like I stayed out of his way, but now he's.
No, I watched that. He did that intentionally, just like I did then to Nemesis. But it should be fine because it was. You don't seem to get much damage from behind in this game. Like it deals out damage to the person who's the
aggressor.
The hitter. Yeah, that's a better word. You Speaking of being an aggressor, I'm going to turn myself into a missile if I get close enough to this guy.
Make sure you do it backwards, though, then you won't take any damage.
Yes, we found an exploit. We're doing the entire race is backwards now.
Woohoo!
I like how we've invented a new racing line there.
Oh, well, no, I'm just following AI. His line so I could be just as fast as him.
An AI just completely spun me. Like, just drove up and said, "You're going the other way now." And that was it.
He liked your idea about ramming people from behind. Yeah. So he's now putting it into motion.
Yeah. No longer a theory. practice. He's the engineer of our group.
I don't think we're going to be able to. Oh no, you're pretty close.
No, I'm gaining on him constantly. Ah, now I fucked it up.
So are you guys like picking on like an NPC?
No, this is a real person.
Oh, is this the guy that joined us?
Yeah.
Yeah. He keeps winning every race because he just turns everyone around.
Well, this sounds like what happened when we did the last time somebody joined, and then we went into Demolition Derby and just destroyed him.
Oh, the AI did it again. I just came near him and they just flung me around. They're really good at pit maneuvers. But yeah, except this last time, the guy that we destroyed in that stream that I forgot to cut out and upload as a separate video, that one, I only just realized I did right then that I didn't do that. the guy in that was actually good. And he drove well, and we still picked on him.
Oh, yeah, that was just this guy, being...
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I see what you're saying. Okay, funny. So you're saying this guy is just in the way.
We're messing around.
Yeah, this guy here is being a jerk and spending people on purpose.
People who play, normally they will upgrade their cars and stuff because we use all the stock cars. It does limit us a bit.
I think I've got upgrades off, hopefully. Upgrades and tuning. Although they could have their own personal cars that are a little bit better.
They could.
His race lane is really bad, though.
It's because he's not using Rando Line Rizian.
Well, then his line would be horrible.
I'm still impressed at how good Line Rizian is at keeping in front of me, painting the lines.
He's got like a spray gun.
He's on like a scooter. And he's just going.
I thought he was tied onto the front bumper.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, he was tied up to the front of the car just spraying. That's...
Or maybe he's got one of those big giant rollers from Splatoons.
He's on a tricycle and he's got one of those rollers. Really fast.
and a helmet, a crash helmet that's too small for his head.
Oh, that reminds me. Me and Smokey watched the Super Mario Brothers movie last night.
Oh my goodness, that was so bad.
With the Goombas with the tiny heads.
Yeah. That movie was so bad.
And the scene when they're in the elevator and Luigi starts making them all start dancing. It's like, hey, it's the NID. And then when the door opens and the other Goomba's like, what are you doing? That would be Boris ruining the fun. It's okay. Next race, I don't even care about winning. I'm just going to ruin him. I'm going to make it so unbearable.
Still another race for these cars?
I believe so.
Woo!
We've maybe been I'm wrong for like 3.5 hours.
3.5 hours?
Give and take 3 hours.
Sure. Sure.
I was trying to take somebody out right at the end and stay in front of them. I don't know if it worked. I don't know if it was Aaron or Marcel, but.
A-A-Ron.
A-A-Ron, that's right. West L.E.
It's not even spelt that way. They are wrong.
It doesn't matter.
Okay, it is going to get hit. Something there, I thought it had stopped.
Race that. If your garage is getting full, call Minty.
I got the same one. That's not. If we're saying goodbye.
I guess.
Bye.
Oh. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.